then go inside and shut the door. Somebody say, shut the door. Shut the door behind you, and your sons pour oil into all the jars, and as each is filled, put it to one side. She left him and shut the door behind her and her sons. They brought the jars to her, and she kept pouring. When all the jars were full, she said to her son, bring me another one. But he replied, there is not a jar left. And the oil stopped flowing. Father, we thank you for your word today. Oh, verse 7, I'm sorry. She went and told the man of God, and he said, go, sell the oil, pay your debts, and you and your sons can live on what is left. Father, we thank you for your word today. It's a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. We thank you, God, for what you're going to do in this place. Have your way in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. I love that song that Minister Kareem, I wish I was a singer, because that song is an old song that one of the pastors from Brand New Life that passed away always sing it. I forgot her name. I really love the Lord. Pastor, yes. I really love the Lord. See, you don't know what he's done for me. He gave me the victory, and I love him. I love him. I really and truly love the Lord. And see, I've come to the conclusion that no matter what comes your way, no matter what the enemy sends, no matter the lack or the disappointments, no matter the sickness, no matter the distraction, no matter the delay, I have come to the conclusion that on Christ, the solid rock I stand, and all the ground is sinking sand. And that's why that song meant so much to me, because it reminded me of where God took me from, where I could have been, where I could have been, where I should have been, but God took me from a miry place, and he placed my feet on solid ground.
My God.
So even when, like the song they sang this morning, even when you don't see it, he's moving.
Yes.
Even when you don't feel it, he's moving. He never stops.
Yes.
The psalm says he never stops moving, but you got to trust him that he's working it together for good. Amen. Somebody need to shout right here. Somebody just need to give God praise right there. Somebody need to tell him, thank you right there. Because even when you're trusting and you don't see him, you still believe that he is God. You still, hallelujah, know that without a shadow of a doubt, he's going to turn that thing around for good. Even when you don't feel like it, even when you don't feel like doing it, God says he's an Ephesians 3:20 God that can do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we ask or think. And so we have to trust him, and we got to move ourselves out the way and make room for what God is getting ready to do. Amen. So in this story of the widow woman, it gives us insight on obedience and faith in God. Amen.
Yes.
And we know the story. It's a very familiar story. But let me ask you this question. What do you do when you're facing problems that look hopeless?
Well,
what do you do
well,
when you have too much month left at the end of your money?
Jesus.
What do you do, hallelujah, glory to God, when your back is against the wall?
Yes.
When you're between a rock and a hard place? What do you do when sickness is trying to take over your body and you're deteriorating from the inside out? What do you do? Well, I'm here to tell you today that this widow woman, she exhibited her faith in God, and she used the principle of Matthew 7:7-8. And what does it say? It says, ask, and it will be given unto you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and the door shall be open. And it says, for everyone who asks will receive, and the one who seeks will find, and the one who knocks, the door will be open. This widow woman did not look to the left nor to the right, but she went straight in to the prophet of God. Ah, God, the mouthpiece of God, the ambassador of God.
Yeah.
And she had faith enough. Her faith never wavered. Even when she was at her last quit. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But she went in, and the first thing she did was remind him of who she was to him. She was connected to him through her husband, who was a son of the prophet. You don't hear me this morning. Sometimes you gotta make sure you're connected to the right people. You're connected to the right source. Glory be to God. Because see, there's no connection. How are you gonna reach him? You gotta go through somebody. When trouble comes your way, you gotta find that prayer warrior. You gotta find that one that's not just gonna have a pity party, but a prayer party. You gotta find Eshara. Because I've made up in my mind that in this new season at 62, I am walking with nobody that don't know how to pray. I am walking with nobody that don't know how to fast. Because I'm in a different place in my life. Because when the enemy comes in like a flood, I need a prayer warrior.
Yes, Lord.
I'm walking with nobody that don't know how to pray. And I'm not going to apologize for it. Because in times like these, we need a savior. In times like these, we need a friend. In times like these, we need
Jesus.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
She was connected to her husband that died.
Thank you, Lord.
He was the son of the prophet. And when she went to Elisha, something was ignited on the inside of him.
Jesus.
Woo! He could have said to her, okay, woman, just go home and pray. But he understood that God don't make mistakes. And God sent her. God sent her straight to him, I'm sorry. God sent her to him. She could have went anywhere else. But watch this. When his response was two questions. What do you need? And what is in your house?
Yes.
Somebody gonna leave here today and share the house. Somebody gonna leave here today and they gonna get the house in order. Because if God was to come up in your house, would he be able to find something that's attached to him? See, some of us have some stuff in our house that needs to go. Some of us have some stuff in our house, not just the physical house, but your body is a temple. Your body houses the Holy Spirit. We're housing anger. We're housing greed. We're housing lust. We're housing jealousy. Some of us have some stuff in us that needs to go. But this woman, she was in a desperate mode. She was at the lowest place in her life.
Thank you, Jesus.
My God.
Woo! She understood that when she was weak, God would be her strength.
Yes.
All right.
She understood that he was Jehovah Jireh. The God that provides it.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
There was no doubt in her mind that God was going to make a way. How do I know that? Because when the prophet said to her, what do you need? And what's in your house? She could have said, what on earth are you asking me that for? I just told you that I'm losing everything. They're about to take my children. And in the Jewish law, what they do is they take, when you owe debt, they take your children and use them as slaves to pay off every debt that is owed. And so she was going to him for help. And but his response was the question, what's in your house? Why are you asking me what's in my house? This woman didn't say that. She said to him, I have a jar of oil. I have a jar of oil in my house. A jar right there means a flask. I have a flask of oil. It's the oil that was used to anoint, that the sons of the prophet was used to anoint the man. And so she had a jar of oil. But guess what, y'all? How many people know that the anointing destroys the oil? All you need is just the oil of his anointing. And when the oil is there, come on, I feel my strength come in. Devil, you a liar. All you need is something that can attach to him, something that's connected to him. Glory be to God. And she got that jar of oil. And she, listen, before I get ahead answer. She obeyed his instructions, Apostle Larry. He said to her, go borrow some pots and pans and jars. I could hear them now. Noah, why are you building a boat when there's a drought? It's under the Messiah. Ah, God, Apostle Larry, why are you still keeping church
in the pandemic?
I can hear them now.
Yeah.
Why are you on a daycare in a pandemic? But when you get a word, somebody, when God gives you a word, nothing by no means can take that from you, because you are connected to the source. Ah, God, hey. I hear the Lord saying,
Jesus.
Somebody, it needs to reconnect today.
Well,
somebody is going to get it today.
Yeah, Lord.
My God.
This woman was obedient to the word of God. Mama, she went and she started borrowing pots. And I know the neighbors must have been like, you are crazy. You losing your Holy Ghost mind. You ain't got much sense right now. What's going to go in the pot when after you have nothing left? You have nothing to turn to. But what they did not see was that there was an invisible God that does supernatural things, that does exceeding and abundant
things,
that can make a way out of no way. There was a God that she was connected to. A God that would turn the wheel, baby, to the heart of the king is in the hands of the Lord, and he can turn that bad boy however he decides to. So this woman was obedient.
Yes, my God.
In her obedience, she exhibited her faith.
Yes. Right.
How many times has God told you something to do?
Right.
It sounds silly and it sounds stupid to you.
Yeah.
But what's impossible by man is possible by God.
Yes.
I'm going
Lord.
Somewhere with this. Watch this. So she went and she borrowed the pots. She understood, hallelujah, that the questions that were asked was not to come against her.
Right.
Was to help her.
Yes.
Was to take her to another place that she's never been before.
All right.
Ooh, she was married to a prophet, and his death, the prophet's death, caused her to go in debt. So she was lacking financially in her life.
Yes.
She was about to lose her children to slavery. They had to work to make sure that every debt was paid. But what am I saying to you today? She was desperate. And God is saying, until you get into a desperate mode, see what he's saying is, I might allow some hard things to happen in your life, and it's going to get you to a place where you have no other choice but to get down on your knees, but to pray without ceasing, but to say, God, it's me, oh Lord, I'm standing in the need of prayer, not my mother, not my brother, but it's me, oh Lord. It's me, oh Lord, I need your help. This woman was in a desperate mode, hallelujah, and her cry out for help was an uncontrollable moan. It was a moan that when God heard that, faith became it was not pity party. She wasn't feeling sorry for herself. She was saying, God, I need you. Every hour, God, I need you. It was an uncontrollable moan. It was a cry from deep down on the inside. Can I ask you a question? Have you ever gotten to that place where you need him? If he don't come, you're going to lose your mind. If he don't move, you're going to lose your mind. But I hear the Lord saying, if you haven't been in it before, you are going to go through it. Get ready. My topic today is make room for more. Because the more that you live, the longer you live, you're going to go through some diapers, temptation. You're going to go through some weapons of warfare. You're going to go through some spiritual activities. You're going to go through some some things that will try to make you sink and take the wonder. But the devil is a liar. This morning, as my husband went through the door, I'm sending my message to my iPad, and the computer crashed.
Jesus.
I saved it, but it wasn't there when I went back. And I said, God, what am I going to do with this? And he said, be still and know
that I am God.
Be still. Put on your smiling face. Confuse the enemy. Hallelujah. Because what the enemy wants is you to get into a depressed mode.
Yes.
For you to start thinking. For you to start saying, I can't do this.
Well,
it's not going to work. But the devil is a liar.
Hallelujah.
Because just like that woman, that widow woman, she did not allow what she see to detour her. Because what she saw was temporary. It was temporary, y'all.
Yes.
It wasn't gonna last forever. It wasn't gonna last forever. See her response. She decided that I'm going to go in and I'm going to make room.
Yeah.
I'm going to borrow these pots and pans. And she went in and she closed the door. And when she closed the door, she began to pour in. It wasn't her natural pouring. It was a spiritual pouring.
Yes, Lord.
The Holy Spirit was all up in her house.
Yeah,
he was all up in her room.
Jesus.
He was all up in her life.
Well.
And even though there was a drought in her life, one moment can change the rest of your life.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
God erased everything just like that, mama. Just like that. Two questions. What do you need? And what do you have in your house? Can I ask you this morning, what do you need? And what do you have in your house? God is saying, go home and make room. Use what you have. It's more than enough. We serve a more than enough God. He's the supplier of all our needs. He makes a way out of no way. And see, by these two questions, let me see the size of her need and the smallness of her own resources. And let me see that what I'm in need of, what you're in need of,
yes,
is small. Hallelujah. To God, I wish I had somebody
yeah,
this morning
Jesus.
That
Hallelujah.
Understood that what your needs are is small.
Yeah.
I ain't trying to be rude, but your little needs are small. It's nothing compared to the sovereign God. It's nothing. We make our needs so big. We make it look like a mountain. Yes, baby. We make it look like a mountain. When God is saying, this is a small thing, Apostle. This is nothing for me to do. But if you don't trust me, it's going to always look big. Because you're magnifying the issue instead of glorifying the God that allowed the issue. Hey, glory to God. This woman did not magnify her lack. She asked and it was given unto her.
Yes.
She seek and she found.
Yes.
She knocked
and the, door
and the prophet opened up the door.
Yes.
Woo! And see, the only thing that limits God is our capacity to receive.
Yes.
The only thing that limits God is our capacity to receive. Maybe over here don't need it, but I'm going to tell somebody over here, the only thing that limits God is our capacity to receive.
Yes.
What am I saying to you? Make room.
Make room. Yes.
Make room. Make room. God told me this week, I'm going to blow your mind. Listen, I'm not talking about just finances. I'm talking about spiritual things in heavenly places. I'm talking about my joy.
Well,
I'm talking about my peace.
Yes,
I'm talking about strength from
yeah.
on high. He's going, if you receive this word this morning, God says, I'm going to blow your mind. I'm going to supersede
yeah.
your expectations.
Yeah,
as you wait on me, as you begin to trust me, know me as Jehovah Ra, the Lord your shepherd, I will make a way in the wilderness. And if one go astray, I'm coming to find you, baby, because I'm going to leave you out, because I'm coming back for a body. I'm coming back for a people that are called by my name, that are sanctified, that are set apart, that are ready to go to the next dimension.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I'm coming
yes,
back
Lord.
To you.
Yes, Lord.
I'm making a way for you. I'm making a way for you. Hallelujah. I'm making a way for you. Glory be to God. This woman needed everything from God, and she had very little. But don't you know that little bit is much when it's in the hands of God?
Yes, yes.
Woo! If it was just a touch of the oil, like this, small thing. Faith as much as a mustard seed.
Yes.
Oh, Shama, that can move mountains, that will cause God to get up off his throne. Hey, Shama, so what does it mean to make room?
Glory.
It means move aside.
Yes. Yes.
Get out of the way.
Yes.
Get your little self out the way.
Well.
Clear the path so that the one and only the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords can enter in. Hey, Shama, who is the King of Kings? Is the Lord of hosts, the Lord God Almighty, the Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty
in battle.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
God will use the trials, the heartaches, the burdens of life, to bring us to the place where we can honestly see our need and our own inability to meet it.
Amen.
Right.
God will allow you to stay in that pit until Joseph, you get it together.
Yes.
God will allow you to be in hurt just so he can get you to the place that he needs you to be.
My Lord.
God will sometimes take some things away from us.
Yes.
Oh, Sharabasaya. Undesheka. Ekondoramasatio.
Hallelujah.
So he can get your attention.
Yes.
He promised Abraham a seed. And when the seed came, now he said, sacrifice that seed. But God is saying, I'm not going to take that seed back because I am an Indian giver.
Well,
but I want to see your faith.
Faith.
I want to see how much you trust me.
Jesus.
So God said, because you went into the secret place of the Most High and you shut the door. When the enemy came in like a flood in your life for the past 2 weeks, the Spirit of God raised up a standard before you. And so you began to pray without season. And you called the people who knew how to pray. And so God, the God that we serve, he responds to faith. When faith is in action, he moves. But when he sees fear in action, one speck of fear, that's why they say one bad apple gets called a whole bunch. One speck of fear will cause God not to move. It will cause him to stand still and still be God. He will still be God because he don't move at your notice. He moves when he wants, how he wants, however he wants, because he's bad like that, and he's God. And you got to respect him, you got to honor him, you got to praise him, you got to glorify him,
hallelujah,
you got to magnify him. He's excellent in all his ways, and in all his ways we acknowledge him as our Lord and personal Savior, as the Shepherd, Emmanuel, God that is with us, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Ra, El Shaddai, Jehovah Nissi.
Yeah.
He's doing something new. The old things have passed away.
Behold, all things become new.
Yeah,
he's doing a new thing. I feel it in my spirit. And that's what keeps us going when we understand that God is not slack according to his promises. He'd never go back on his word. He will not be God. He has to keep his promise. But you have to wait it out.
Yes. Wait it out.
It's not time to move. Wow. Until God says to move.
Yes.
You might be on the ledge like I'm on the edge. And you might be saying, God, I feel like I'm about to fall over. God, I can't take this no more. But God says, you haven't fallen, right? Right. You're on the ledge, but you haven't fallen. You're still hanging on.
Who do
you think is holding you up? Who do you think is holding you up?
Yeah, Lord.
Who you think is holding you up? I'm on the ledge, but I won't fall because the great I am is on the scene, and he's covering, and he's keeping, and he's holding you. That hand that you don't see, when you don't see it, believe it. He's doing it. Trust me, the God that we serve is the invisible God.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
He's the invisible God.
My God. Thank you, Jesus.
He is the invisible.
Hallelujah.
And I hear the Lord saying,
Hallelujah.
I want to fill you up.
Jesus. Well.
But I can't fill you when you're full.
Yes.
When you're full of yourself.
Well. Preach.
When you're full of pride.
Preach. Jesus.
That's why you're not getting the fullness of God. Because we're so full of ourselves. We need to empty ourselves so he can refill us to the overflow. The woman, but she had so much oil, she didn't have room enough to receive it. So much oil. And the same oil is what made provision for her.
Yes, Jesus.
Go sell it.
Well.
Go sell it.
Yes.
And the rest of it you can live on. Pay the debts.
Well,
that's one thing that God reminded me this week. Owe no man nothing but to love them.
Amen.
Debts are supposed to be paid. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
We can't go asking God for more when we owe. We have to get it right.
Yes.
Amen.
So my prayer this week to God was, Lord, help me to clear my debts.
Yes.
Let me not put myself into more debts. But God, help me to clear. I think everybody should say that.
Yes.
God, help me. Because God is laughing at us like, okay, you're asking me for increase. But you don't even have the capacity to receive it because you owe so much. Ask me to pay your debt.
Amen.
Ask me to clear your debt.
Well.
So when I clear your debt, I'm making all things new.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
We got to empty ourselves of everything, Mama, in order for God to refill us.
Well,
so we can be more effective
in
the kingdom of God.
Yes, Lord.
Because sometimes the reason why people can't receive from us is because we're so full of ourselves. We're not full of His Spirit, and we're not walking by His Spirit. But we're so full of ourselves. And God is saying this morning, I want you to begin. Just take 30 seconds and empty yourselves. Just begin to acknowledge Him. If you're watching a live stream, begin to lift your hands wherever you are. Begin to empty yourself. Come on. Just say, God, I surrender all to you. I've messed up so much in my life, God. Oh, God, I know you've been blessing me over and over and over and over again, God. God, empty me, God. I'm not going to worry about the person next to me. God, I'm concerned about me now, God. It's me and you, Jesus. Empty me, God. Empty my home. Empty my heart. Oh, so I can be a better mother. I can be a better wife. I can be a better sister. I can be a better minister. A better deacon. A better pastor. God, empty me. Empty me so that you can use me for your glory, God. Take away everything that's not like you. Every fear. Every doubt, God. Take it away, God.
Yes.
Take the courage of pride. Oh, Shabba. In the name of Jesus, God. Empty me, God. Empty me, God. Oh, God. Empty me. Empty me. God, because I really, really love you, God. I love you with all my heart. Come on, he's filling somebody
love
right
me,
now.
Love
oh, fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, Jesus. And sometimes God wants you to do something to prove yourself to him.
Jesus.
He will take you to some hard places, because what God wants to do is expand your faith.
Well,
he wants to take your faith to another level.
Yes.
Listen, just having just faith as a mustard seed is good.
Well,
but there is such a thing as crazy faith. Faith to walk on water.
Jesus.
Faith that takes it to another dimension. Faith to believe when you don't even see it. Faith to say, no matter the number, we still have in church. Faith to say, God, I trust you because you sent me. Faith to stand up in the front of the enemy when the judge says you will be deported. Faith to say, God, I still trust y'all. God, I still believe y'all. When the judge says you're going to jail, faith to say, God, even in that, you still will get every glory out of your life, God. Faith to say, with cancer, when the doctor tells you you have a few months to live, just as your mother lived many more years, faith to believe and cry out to God. Faith is the substance of
things
hoped for,
and
evidence of things not seen. Faith to take it by force. Faith to know that the time is now. Faith to believe that defeat is not an option. Faith to trust God. You need that faith, just like this woman.
Well,
I believe in my spiritual mind that maybe there was a little doubt, but she didn't let doubt
take her
leave her
yes.
or take her there.
Yes.
She was obedient by faith.
Amen.
Because every now and again, God will send you something, and you're like, okay, God, how is this? Okay, God, I trust you. All right, God, I trust you. Because you have to have faith enough to believe that what he says, he's able to come through. His
My
promises
God.
Are yes,
yes and amen.
And amen. He's not a man that he should lie.
Yes.
Not that he's the son of man that he should repent. If he says it, if God says it. And how do I know if God says it? He said, my sheep will hear my voice.
Well,
and a stranger, they will not follow. Whose voice are you following? Are you following the doctor's voice? Are you following the lawyer's voice? Are you following your teacher's voice? Or your husband or your wife's voice? Or are you following God's voice?
Well,
can you declare this morning in this room that God is your refuge?
Thank you, Jesus.
He's a present help in times of need. Though the waters might roar, it won't take you under, because he keeps you in the shadow of the Almighty.
Yellow.
He is the Almighty God. He is from everlasting to everlasting. And you know, we look at it and we said, wow, this is in the Old Testament. But we see God doing this even in the new.
Yes.
And past the new, the now.
Yeah.
He's still doing miracles with signs and wonders. Miracles miracle. Maybe he healed you 20 years ago. That was then, but he still can do it now. Maybe he took you out of lack about a year ago. But God can still do the same thing right now. Come on, somebody just shout, right now.
Right now.
Somebody just shout, right now. Do it right now, God. I believe God, I receive God. Do it right now, 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 right now. Do it right now, God. Do it. Somebody here is still believing, God. The enemy's trying to erase your faith, trying to make you think that it's not going to work. But God said to tell you it's working together for good, according to his timing. His timing is impeccable. I feel it in my spirit. He's doing it for you. He's doing it for you. Instead of having a peace party and worrying about the situation, how about have a praise party? Can we give him a praise break? Can we just give him a praise break? A 30-second praise. God, we thank you. God, we love you. God, we love you. God, you're worthy. God, you're worthy. God, you're worthy. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Everything that has held you in captivity is coming to an is coming to an end. You can walk in the freedom of God, because where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Come on, you walk in the freedom of God. Because Jessica is coming to an end. Nothing by no means can harm you. Every struggle, every pressure is coming to an end. I see it in the spirit. 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 What's that woman? The little woman was at the end of her rope, and there was some rope hanging over, and she didn't know what to do. She didn't know where to go, but she looked to the hill. Whether it's your time, you today, God. We bless your holy name this morning, God. We thank you, God, that you never stop working. Oh, God, we're opening up our hearts, God, and we're making room for you, our good shepherd. The good shepherd that giveth his life for the sheep. God, we thank you that nothing by no means can harm us, God, because we put all our trust in you. We believe you're our poor God. We know that you're able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we ask or think. Somebody in this room is rejoicing today and exceedingly glad, because great is their reward in heaven. God, you always come through. You always make a way. And we're humbled this Shadarasaya by your gratefulness towards us, God. Great is your mercies each day, God. Oh, God, we don't deserve it, God. But your grace is sufficient for us, God. And your strength is made perfect in weakness. So, God, we thank you for those that made it in this morning, God. And those that are watching today, Holy Spirit. God, we ask you to take full control.
Yes.
Go before us today, God. And let every enemy be scattered. God, we surrender our will to your will, God. We surrender our way to your way, God. We know that you are the ultimate God, the sovereign God, the everlasting Father. And we take a moment today just to tell you thank you. Father God, we thank you. We thank you this morning, God. Oh, we bless your name, God. Because God, you've protected us from so much, God. Oh, God, we travel over the highways and the byways, God. From going into our homes and coming home, God. You comfort us, God. You keep us, God. When sickness tries to take over our bodies, God, you healed us, God. Oh, Father, we thank you for every new chapter that we turn in this life with you, God, this walk with you. Oh, we would never do it any other way, God. We love you this morning, God, with all our hearts, with all our soul, with everything that's within us, God. We bless your holy name. Oh, magnify the Lord with me today, and let us exalt his name together. God, you said this poor man cried out, and you heard, God. God, somebody's crying out. Somebody's crying out that's watching today. Somebody needs you in a different way, God. Oh, it might not be the way of the widow woman, God, but somebody needs you today. God, we pray for every unspoken request in this house, God. Oh, Shadarasata, every demon that we're fighting against, we come against them now with the blood of Jesus Christ. And Father God, we loose your spirit of peace over our homes, over our lives, over our minds. God, we saturate this place with your anointing. Let the anointing of God do the work. Father, we thank you that we're going to be obedient. Help us, God, to be more obedient to your word. God, when you say, when you send us, God, we will go. When you say, stand still, we will not move a muscle, God. We will be obedient to your every word. God, I pray, Father God, for your people throughout this coming week, that you will blow their minds. Exceed their expectations, God. Father, let them walk line upon line and precept upon precept. Father, we thank you in advance for everything that you have allotted us in this community, God. We thank you for the 10 years of being here, God. Yes, God. Oh, Father God, we know everything has a meaning to you, God. And so, God, we thank you, Rosha, one decade, Father, with more to come, Father. We are grateful this morning. Oh, we bless your holy name, God. And Father God, even as we get ready to celebrate the 10th year, Father, We thank you, Father, that you've gone before it, God, and everything that you desire, your will be done. Father, we ask you to have your way in this place, God. Have your way in this place, God. We raise the praise in this place, God. We raise the praise in our hearts, God. We raise the praise in this place, God. We give it all back to you, Jesus. Oh, God, we surrender our will to your will, God. You are God. You are God. For this, God, we say thank you, and we love you, God, in Jesus' name. Come on, let's give God praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank you this morning, God. Oh, we thank you this morning, Jesus. Oh, we thank you this morning, God. Oh, we bless you, God. Oh, Father God, we surrender our will to you, God. We surrender our way to you, God. Father God, we thank you for good reports this week, God. We thank you for covering us this week, God. For some reason, God, just have me praying over the next 7 days. The Bible says no good thing will he withhold from them that love him. And so because we're called by his name, then the next 7 days, God is going to exceed our expectations. He's going to blow our minds. And I receive it now in the mighty name of Jesus. And just like the widow woman, we're walking in obedience, we're walking in faith, because faith is the substance of things hoped for, and obedience is better than sacrifice. And so we're walking, Father, according to your will and your promises for our lives, God. We're not going to get detoured, Father. We're not going to look to the left or the right, but we're going to look to the hills from whence cometh our help, because we know that all our help comes from you, God. And we have the victory, God. We believe it, God. We claim it, God. We proclaim it, God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we are standing on Christ, the solid rock we stand. All other ground is sinking sand. We will not trust what our emotions tell us, God, but we will trust in the Lord with all our heart. We will lean not on our own understanding. In all our ways, we will acknowledge him, and he shall, he will.
Hallelujah.
Our path. So yeah, we thank you this morning, God. Oh, as we travail in the realm of the spirit, we're believing you this morning that though he slay me, yet will I trust him. We believe, Father, that even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we shall fear no evil, for you are with us, God. You're gone before us, God. We believe that now we shall look, lift up our eyes unto the hills from whence cometh our help. And we know that all our help comes from you, oh God. You are the author and the finisher of our faith, and we trust you, and we believe you, and we stand on your word, oh Father, because your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. We love you today, God. We honor you today, God. We give you all the praise and all the glory today, and we say thank you. We thank you. We bless you, God. We honor you, Lord God. You are stronger than your struggles. You are stronger than your struggles. And God's going to make a way out of no way for each and every one of us. But we got to trust it. And we got to be obedient. And we got to make sure that our convictions about God are so strong that no matter what comes our way, we will not get torn or revert to being who we used to be. May God bless you today. May God cover you today. May the Spirit of God be with you. In Jesus' name, amen.